Hello, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Akash Marasini, and I'm working as a data analyst in the Cloud Seva. So yesterday we have discussed about theoretical concept of EMR, Hadoop, and Spark. So in this session, we are going to discuss how EMR, Hadoop, and Spark can be used for big data processing and perform some analysis. So let's discuss what we will going to do today. So first of all, we will create an EMR cluster, and we will add Hadoop and Spark into it. Similarly, we will copy multiple CSV files along with the Spark script that will perform some analysis and some big data processing into the EMR cluster by using the command s3-dist-cp. Similarly, we will run the Spark script that will perform some data processing and analysis by using the command spark-submit. Finally, we will obtain a CSV file in the Hadoop cluster after the processing and analysis are done by running the Spark script. And this CSV file will be again transmitted into the S3 bucket. And the CSV file will be looks like this appearing in the screen. Here we will get the number of people according to the gender and age in the descending order. So let's go toward the AWS management console. So this is the AWS EMR console. As we are going to create a EMR cluster, so just select EMR, and click here. This is the cluster name, that is new cluster, which has been created already. So we are going to create a new cluster. So just click it here, click, and go to advanced option. As we are going to install the Hadoop and Spark in our EMR cluster, so we are going to select both of them. Hadoop is already selected, and now we have to select Spark too. And leave the other option as a default, and click on next. And here also leave the other option as a default in cluster composition and networking, and go towards the cluster nodes and instance. Here we will choose the cluster nodes and select the instance. So first of all, we are going to select the instance type for master node. According to our dataset, we are choosing the EM4 large. Click on save. And similarly for core node also, we are taking EM4 large. Click and save. We are taking only one instance. Taking higher number of instance is it cost you more. So only select the number of instance according to your data. And we are not using the task node here. And leave the other option as a default and click on next. And give the name new cluster. And leave the other option as a default and click on next. As we have already created the cluster in our system, so we are not going to create now. It mainly takes around 15 minutes to create cluster. So I'm just canceling this option. So I'm not going to create cluster now because the cluster is already created in our YAML cluster and we are going to use that cluster. This is our cluster, that is a new cluster. Okay, click it here. And we can see here, there is a security group for master node, core and task node. So here we are going to select security group for master node. So just click it here. And select for security group ID for master node, already our master node. And then go on edit inbound rule. Add a new rule. And here we should get the port number, sorry. So just go here and go to application user interface. And this is the port number for our SGFS name node. Copy this port and paste here. And select the IP address 0.0.0.0. And click on save rules. And again, go back to the EMR console and go to summary. Sorry, go to application user interface and open this link. This is our Hadoop interface. And just go to utilities and open the browse file system or click the browse file system. Now we are going to copy the CSV files and Spark script from our public S3 bucket into the SGFS. So go to steps and click it here and click on add step and step type is custom jar and give the name for the copy spark and copy script and CSV file. Files into SGFS cluster and start location will be command command.jar is installed in EMR. Which allows us to run particular commands on cluster. So now we are going to give the argument. Here we will use the command to copy CSV files and Spark script file into the SGFS. Command is just dist for copying of the file, and we should give the source and destination. So our source will be this, which is the public S3 bucket, and our destination will be SGFS or Hadoop cluster. Okay, and click on add. It takes some amount of time for transferring the file from public S3 bucket into the Hadoop. status is pending. It will take some around 4 to 5 minutes for complete transfer of file, CSV file and Spark script file from S3 bucket into the SDFS. Those file will be appeared here. Yes, user data SCG is appearing. Our command is running here. It is taking some time. Yes, the status is completed. It means all the files has been copied from S3 into the SDFS. So let's check here by refreshing here. Yes, both the files has been appeared here. First one is user data SCG. It contains number of CSV files. And next one is PySpark script. It is the Spark script that will perform some data processing and perform some analysis over the CSV file. Okay. Now, let's see the diagram. Here we have copied CSV file and Spark script file into the EMR Hadoop cluster. And now we are going to run the Spark script that will do some processing and some analysis over those CSV files. Okay. Let's look over into the Spark script file. Okay. First of all, look here it will read all the CSV file from SDFS cluster, that is from this SDFS. It loads all the data and read all those CSV files, and it creates a data frame that group the data by users, age and gender, and count the number of users and order them in descending format, and write the result to a CSV file and store them on SDFS cluster. Okay. First of all, it will read all the CSV file and it does some processing analysis here, and then finally it writes the result into again the SDFS. Okay, might have you understood this Spark script. Now we are going to run the Spark script file that I have shown you right now. For this, again, add step. Step type is a custom jar and give the name for the step that is running PySpark jar location is not there, and argument will be spark dash submit and location of the file. Yes, this command is used for running the Spark script file, and this is the location of the Spark script file. Okay, this will run the this file and click on add. It will also take some minutes for running this script. Yes, completed. All the processing has been done, and the Spark script has been successfully run. Let's see what changes can be seen in this Hadoop interface. Just refresh it here. Yes, the new folder has been appeared, which is the result, and it contains the CSV file, this file. Let's again go back to our diagram. Our file has been appeared in the HDFS in EMR cluster. Now we are going to copy this file into the S3 bucket here. And the file contain the data looks like that look like this. It contains the number of people according to the gender and age, where we have used group by using the age and gender, and we have used count in the descending order. Copy files from DFS to S3 command runner dot jar. It we have to put the final result file into the S3 bucket. So we should create a S3 bucket first of all. So create a S3 bucket. We are going to create a S3 bucket. And click here, create bucket, and give the bucket name for user data analytics. And click on create bucket and leave the other option as a default. bucket with the same name already exists, so we should change the name here. Sorry. Yes, it is saying that successfully created bucket user data analytics. Copy this S3 bucket name that we will require later on. Now we are going to give the path. Yes, S3 dist cp is the command to copy any file in the EMR. So we are going to copy the file from HDFS from here to our S3 bucket. So we are going to copy the file from HDFS into the S3 bucket. So our source will be this, and our destinations will be this. Okay. And click on add. It will also take some minutes for transferring the file from HDFS cluster into the S3 bucket. Yes, it is saying that the file has been completely transferred into the S3 bucket. It is saying the status is completed. Let's check into the S3 bucket. Just refresh it. Click it here. Yes, this is the file, CSV file. So open it. So I am downloading this file. Final result. Click it and save. Final result or the CSV file that we have downloaded from the S3 bucket. It contains the number of male and female according to their age. Let's go into the diagram. Let's discuss what we have done today. First of all, we have created an EMR cluster and we have installed the Hadoop and Spark into it. And then we copied CSV files as well as a Spark script file into the EMR Hadoop cluster. And then we run the Spark script that performs some data processing and some analysis by using grouping. And then the new CSV file has been obtained in the Hadoop with name was result, and we transported or we transmitted that file from SDFS into the S3 bucket, and we have downloaded the CSV file into our system. Thank you everyone for joining with us. Similarly, we will also conduct different workshops related to data science and analytics using different AWS services like Redshift, QuickSight. We will cover those topics in our coming sessions. Thank you.